In the previous lecture, we derived the expression of amount of energy which is transferred to the electrons in the medium when the heavy charged particle travels a unit path length inside the medium. So the expression of dE by dx, this gives us the energy transferred to the electrons of the medium in unit length by the incoming heavy charged particle. So this was the expression that we got, and we solved this expression. This came out to be equal to z square. Now z, it is the z into e plus ze is the amount of charge which is present on the heavy charged particle. So z comes from there. So z square e power 4 into n. Now n is the number of electrons which are present in the medium per unit volume, divided by 4 pi epsilon naught square mass of electron into square of the velocity of heavy charged particle. And when you will solve this, you will get natural log of B max over B minimum. Now this is the energy which is transferred to the electrons of the medium in unit length by the incoming heavy charged particle. So this is the expression of energy transferred. Now if energy is transferred to the electrons of the medium by the heavy charged particle, the same amount of energy will be lost by the heavy charged particle. So the energy which is lost by the incoming heavy charged particle will be just given by minus dE by dx. So this will give us the amount of energy which is lost by the incoming heavy charged particle. So that will be equal to same, the energy which is lost, that is same given by this expression. Z square into e power 4 n divided by 4 pi epsilon naught square m e into v square natural log of b max over b minimum. So the energy which is transferred to the electrons of the medium is same as that of the energy lost by the incoming heavy charged particle. So just to differentiate between the two expressions, we write over here a negative sign. Now this minus dE by dx, this quantity is very important. Minus dE by dx is the energy loss per unit path length by the heavy charged particle. So energy loss per unit path length inside the medium. This minus dE by dx, this term is also called as specific energy loss. So energy loss per unit path length is also termed as specific energy loss, and it is also called as stopping power of the medium. So this expression minus dE by dx is also termed as stopping power of the medium. Now what are these values of B max and B minimum? So what are the values of B max and B minimum? So let's suppose if we insert the value of B minimum as 0 and B maximum as infinity. So that will give us the energy loss will be just equal to, it will be undefined, it will give us the absurd result. So if B minimum is equal to 0, if you insert the value of B minimum as 0 and B maximum if you put it as equal to infinity, that will give you absurd results. So this will give you absurd result. So what are the values that we should insert in the case of B max and B minimum? So for evaluating B max and B minimum, we use quantum mechanical approach. So we will use the quantum mechanical approach to evaluate B max and B minimum. Now we are going to determine the value of B max. B max is the maximum amount of the impact parameter which is possible inside the medium. So if we consider a heavy charged particle entering a medium, so this is the absorbing medium. So heavy charged particle is entering in this medium, and this medium is composed of large number of atoms, and there are orbital electrons that revolve around the nucleus of every atom. So there are orbital electrons which are revolving around the nucleus of the atoms of the medium. So these orbital electrons, they take a certain amount of time to complete one revolution around the nucleus, means they have a certain frequency of revolution. So this nu is the total number of revolutions in 1 second of the orbital electron. And if you inverse, if you take the reciprocal, that will give us the time for one revolution. Time to complete one revolution will be given by 1 divided by nu. Now the incoming particle will change the state of orbital electron only if its time of collision is smaller than the electron's time of revolution. As we have said that, let's suppose there is electron in the medium and the heavy charged particle is traveling in this direction. So the heavy charged particle, as it is, its mass is quite high. So we consider that the heavy charged particle goes undeviated inside the medium. So this is also an assumption that we take in the case of heavy charged particles, that they are almost undeviated inside the medium. And in the case of light charged particles, we will see that their path inside the medium is zigzag. So this is one difference between heavy charged particle traveling in the medium and the light charged particle traveling in the medium. Now, according to the semi-classical theory of collision, so the heavy charged particle is traveling in the medium and it will interact with this electron, and the impact parameter is equal to small b, and the velocity of heavy charged particle is given by v. So according to the semi-classical theory of collision, the time of collision is equal to b divided by v. So time of collision, so this heavy charged particle is interacting with this electron, so we call it as a collision. So there is not, the actual collision is not taking place, these both charged particles, they are interacting via Coulombic force, so that also comes under the collision. So the heavy charged particle is traveling in the medium and it will interact with this electron, and this heavy charged particle will lose its energy and transfer a portion of its energy to this electron. So according to semi-classical theory of collision, the time of this collision is given by impact parameter divided by the velocity of heavy charged particle. And according to quantum mechanics, the incoming particle will change the state of orbital electron only if its time of collision is smaller than electron's time of revolution. So this electron is not stationary, it is actually revolving around the nucleus, so it has a certain time period, the time that it takes to complete one revolution around the nucleus. So this incoming particle will change the state of this electron. By changing the state of the orbital electron, we mean that it will cause excitation or ionization in the atom. The electron is a part of the atom. So this heavy charged particle will change the state of the orbital electron, that is, it will cause excitation, ionizations, only if its time of collision is smaller than electron's time of revolution. So this heavy charged particle will transfer its energy, it will transfer a portion of its energy only if the time of collision is smaller than the electron's time of revolution around the nucleus. So this is from quantum mechanics. So the time of collision is given by b divided by v. So if b divided by v, this is the time of collision, time of collision must be smaller than, this time of collision must be smaller than the electron's time of revolution, and electron's time of revolution is given by 1 divided by nu. So nu is the frequency of revolution of the electron, and 1 divided by nu will give us the electron's time of revolution, means 1 divided by nu will be nothing but the time taken by the orbital electron to complete one revolution around the nucleus of the atom. So the time of collision must be less than 1 divided by nu. So if the time of collision is less than 1 divided by nu, now this v, velocity of the heavy charged particle, this can be taken on the right hand side. So b will be less than v divided by nu. So impact parameter must be less than v divided by nu. So what will be the maximum value of the impact parameter which is possible? That is, so maximum value of the impact parameter which is possible, that is equal to v divided by nu. So the impact parameter must be less than this ratio. So the maximum possible impact parameter, the maximum possible value of the impact parameter is equal to v divided by nu. So this is the value of the maximum impact parameter. Now we are going to find out the value of the expression of the minimum impact parameter which is possible. So the minimum value of impact parameter is actually found out from the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. So Heisenberg's uncertainty principle states that delta x into delta p is of the order of Planck's constant. So for evaluating the value of, for evaluating b minimum, we will use the uncertainty principle. Delta x into delta p is equal to h. So to find the exact value of b minimum, we will use this expression. We will use the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Now to find the minimum value in this uncertainty, minimum uncertainty, the uncertainty in momentum must be maximum. So the if the uncertainty in position is minimum, then uncertainty in momentum is maximum in that case. So delta x will be b minimum in this case. So the minimum impact parameter has to be found out. We will use this Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. So if you will insert in place of delta x minimum, in place of delta x minimum, you have b minimum. So we want to find what is b minimum, the minimum value of impact parameter. Now minimum value of impact parameter cannot be equal to zero, and that's because according to uncertainty principle, this delta x cannot be equal to zero, because if delta x is equal to zero, the uncertainty in momentum will be equal to infinity. So delta x, this minimum value of the impact parameter, must be a finite value. It cannot be a zero value. It cannot be zero. It must be a non-zero value. So b minimum into delta p maximum. So if uncertainty is minimum, then if uncertainty in position is minimum, then uncertainty in momentum must be maximum. So that is equal to Planck's constant. So from here, first we will evaluate delta p max, which is possible, and from there we will find out the minimum value of the impact parameter. So maximum amount of momentum we have to find out the maximum change in momentum which is possible. So maximum change in momentum is possible when there is head-on collision. When there is a head-on collision means the heavy charged particle is directly interacting with the electron. There is a head-on collision over here. So in the case of head-on collision, maximum amount of momentum and energy is transferred to the electron. So here this will give us the minimum impact parameter. So first we will evaluate the maximum change in the momentum which is possible. From there we will evaluate B minimum. So delta P max, the maximum change in momentum which is possible, that will be evaluated by considering a heavy charged particle over here, the heavy charged particle of mass capital M and with the charge equal to Ze, and it is moving with the velocity v. So this electron is present over here, and this heavy charged particle is going towards the electron. So there is a head-on collision. Now the mass of the electron is given by Me. So in this first diagram, the electron is considered to be stationary and the heavy charged particle is moving towards it. So there is a head-on collision. So in the case of head-on collision only, there is a maximum change in the momentum possible. So therefore, we have taken only the head-on collision over here. So over here, the heavy charged particle is moving towards the electron with velocity v. Now we are going to find out delta P max. To find delta P max, the maximum change in momentum, we will consider the heavy charged particle to be at rest. So this is the laboratory frame. This first diagram which I have drawn, that is in the laboratory frame, means the electron is at rest and the heavy charged particle, we are making the heavy charged particle to go towards the electron. That is, the heavy charged particle is moving inside the medium. So this is the laboratory frame. Now we are changing the frame of reference. Now we are taking the frame of reference in which the heavy charged particle is at rest. So if heavy charged particle is at rest, then in that frame the electron will be seen to be moving towards the heavy charged particle. So this you have to imagine, that if the heavy charged particle, in actual practice what is happening, in actual practice the heavy charged particle is going towards electron, but now we are changing our frame of reference. We are changing our frame of reference means we are now moving along the heavy charged particle. The frame which we are considering, the another frame which we are supposing over here, that frame is moving with the heavy charged particle with same velocity v. So if that frame of reference is moving with same velocity v, so in that frame the heavy charged particle will appear to be stationary. So the heavy charged particle will be at rest in that new frame of reference. And in that frame of reference, the electron will appear to be moving towards heavy charged particle. So if you are moving along with the heavy charged particle with velocity v, that is the frame of reference which you are considering is moving with velocity v. So in that frame of reference, the heavy charged particle will appear to you at rest and electron will be moving towards you with velocity v, with same velocity v. So to find delta P max, we are considering this second frame of reference which is moving along with the heavy charged particle with same velocity v. So in this second frame, if the electron is moving towards the heavy charged particle and if there is a head-on collision over here, then this electron will be retracing its path in the opposite direction. So if there is head-on collision over here, what will happen? The electron will strike the heavy charged particle and it will be moving in the opposite direction. So there it will retrace its path in the opposite direction. So what is the initial momentum of the electron in this case? What is the initial momentum? We want to find the maximum change in momentum, and maximum change in momentum occurs only in the case of head-on collision. That is, only in this particular case, in the case of head-on collision. So to find delta P max, first we will find out our initial momentum, then we will find out our final momentum, and then we will subtract both values of the momentum and we will get the maximum change in momentum from there. So what is the initial momentum of the electron? Initial momentum of the electron is, momentum is given by mass into velocity. So mass of the electron is me and it is moving with velocity v, but it is moving in the negative direction. So we are considering this axis as the negative direction and this axis as the positive direction or the positive axis. So what is the initial momentum of the electron? It is equal to mass of electron into the velocity of the electron, but in the negative direction. So momentum, initial momentum of the electron is equal to minus me into v, and when it will strike this heavy charged particle, when it will collide, it will retrace its path in the opposite direction. So in that case, what will be the final momentum? Final momentum will be equal to same me into v, because it will retrace its path in the opposite direction with the same velocity. And since it is moving in the opposite direction, here we will have a positive sign. So what is the change in momentum in this case? The change in momentum will be equal to final momentum minus initial momentum, and that will be equal to me into v minus of minus mev. So that will be just 2me into v. So this is the maximum change in momentum. And why it is maximum? Because there is head-on collision. Here we have considered a head-on collision. So delta P max is equal to 2me into v. So using this Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, we will find out B minimum. So B minimum into delta P max is equal to H Planck's constant. From here we will find B minimum, and that will be equal to H divided by delta P max. And what is delta P max? It is equal to 2ME into V. And in the previous page, on the previous page, we have already evaluated the expression of minus dE by dx, and that came out to be equal to z square e power 4 n divided by 4 pi epsilon naught square mass of electron into v square, and we had natural log of b max over b minimum. So b max is v divided by nu, so we will insert the value of b max, that is v divided by nu. So b max is v divided by nu, and in the denominator we had b minimum, so b minimum is h divided by 2mev. So when you will insert the value of b minimum in the expression of minus dE by dx, you will get h divided by 2me into v. So this will be equal to z square e power 4 n divided by 4 pi epsilon naught square mev square into natural log of 2mev square divided by h nu. So this is the expression of minus dE by dx after putting the values of b minimum and b maximum, and this formula, this is called as Bohr's formula of energy loss, or it is also called as Bohr's formula simply, or Bohr's formula for stopping power. So we will write it as Bohr's formula for energy loss. So this is the final formula which was given by Bohr for the energy loss or the specific energy loss. Now after this, the scientists Bethe and Bloch, they actually corrected these values of B maximum and B minimum using the relativistic theory. So using relativistic theory, they made certain corrections in B max value and B minimum value, and again they inserted the new corrected values of B minimum and B maximum, and they inserted it in this formula again. The corrected values of B maximum and B minimum were inserted in this formula, and that formula is called as Bethe-Bloch formula.